carbon, climate, neutral, zero, positive, negative. There are so many terms you'll hear to do with reducing our environmental impact, it's easy to get confused. So let's start with the simplest, the first step to take on our climb to minimal impact, carbon neutral. To be carbon neutral, the amount of greenhouse gas released is matched by reductions elsewhere. This is emissions offsetting through carbon credits. Buying credits helps fund carbon avoidance projects around the world, like renewable energy generation or forest protection. For example, say a company emits 1,000 tons of carbon in a year through its activities and value chain. It then buys credits to save 1,000 tons of carbon from being released elsewhere. Emissions are compensated for, and the company is carbon neutral. It works for individuals too, and even one-off events. Perhaps a large international conference estimates its likely emissions to be 300 tons of carbon. Delegates have to travel, and the venue must be powered. By buying the equal amount in carbon offset credits, the event can be advertised as carbon neutral. But carbon neutral doesn't actually cut how much carbon ends up in the atmosphere. And it doesn't take into account less immediate indirect emissions. So we need to go a step further and aim for net zero emissions. An international target of net zero emissions by 2050 was agreed at the Paris Climate Summit. Meeting this target will help limit global warming to 1.5 degrees Celsius this century. Net zero is also about neutralizing emissions, but it starts with attempts to cut how much carbon ends up in the atmosphere in the first place. So a company, or country, or individual works out its total emissions and puts these on one side of the scale. Activities like manufacturing, transportation, and buildings all add up. Then, less obvious indirect emissions are factored in. These might include emissions released by a supplier when they make a product's component, or for the international conference example, the food miles of the catering. Next, in line with laws and targets, emissions are reduced, ideally 45% by 2030. In our example, the first step might be that the office and factory are renovated to high efficiency standards and energy now comes from renewable sources. Then the manufacturing process is streamlined. Perhaps the supplier makes their own emissions reductions. Finally, the fleet of vehicles becomes electric. It's hard to completely avoid emissions, so instead, any greenhouse gases that are still released are neutralized by investment in carbon removal projects. This is where carbon is taken out of the atmosphere and locked away, either naturally or using technology. Emissions can now be called net zero. Of course, in the real world, it's rarely so simple or clear-cut, but it's what we're aiming for. And after this, what do we find at the top of our climb to minimal environmental impact? Climate positive action, sometimes called carbon negative, goes beyond net zero and tips the balance in favor of carbon removal. The ambitious aim is not just to avoid doing damage, but to improve the natural world. This could create positive feedback loops, seen in examples like regenerative agriculture and zero heating buildings. It's like when small lifestyle changes lead to a critical mass of positive effects. One good thing leads to another, and we're on the way to a healthier, cleaner, greener future.